Salim sir, you can begin the session, sir.
Yes, sir. Good evening, one and all. Today, 442 session. So, all the participants, we are welcoming all the participants because we are traveling more than a year. Today, we are having the person, Dr. Vasavi. He is the head of the department and HOD and Department of Psychology, Salem. He is a qualified MSc Clinical Psychology. He done undergraduate and PhD College of Arts and Science. And he is working with the transgender and teenagers for the 4 years. He published articles in elderly mental health and published in a book called Women's Mental Health during the lockdown. And she is a counselor as well. She received the Best Counselor Award 2020. From Rotary Club Huzur, and she received the Young Achievers Award 2020 from Coimbatore. And she is a resource person for the so many webinars. And with this note, I am welcoming Dr. Vasavi Madam. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And thanks for the warm welcome. So, how can I tell my phone? Is it fine?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
So, I'm here today to speak about children's mental health today. So, as this pandemic started, everyone is in a crisis right now. Actually, we adults are suffering a lot. So, I thought of speaking about children's mental health at this time. I think that may be useful. So, what we have to concentrate on children's mental health and what are all the aspects we have to concentrate, how they are reacting. Of course, everyone will be having our kids at our home. So we should concentrate on them. It is not that they are happy always. It is not that they are enjoying their holidays now. It is almost 2 years that schools are shut. So they'll be missing their friends. They'll be missing their school. They'll be missing their teachers. Or there will be a lot of problems inside them. So we need to focus on that. So we have to speak to them. We have to understand their emotions as well. So we'll see what are all the aspects we need to concentrate. Is it visible, sir?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Can you? So, first, how is your child during this pandemic? We need to talk about children's mental health. This is the important aspect first we need to concentrate, because children may not be in the position to tell everything to us, and we have to understand if they are not telling to us also. Even adults are having some problems. We are not ready to expose our emotions to somebody else. So when it comes to children, they'll be very sensitive. They'll be very reserved in the matter of mental health. So we need to concentrate on them. We need to talk about that. So we need to spend some time with our children. We need to ask them continuously, is there any problem? Are you okay? Everything is fine. So I guess during this pandemic, all the older people are working from home. So they'll be there. That is a hectic time for them with managing their work and managing their home also. So even especially ladies are facing a lot of problems during this pandemic, because we have to concentrate on children also. There'll be a lot of behavioral issues in their children also as well. So this is a most hectic time for everybody, economically, emotionally, physically, and all the aspects are suffering very bad. So this is one aspect where we have to concentrate on children's mental health, because when they start, we need to. Is it fine, sir?
Ma'am, I think you stop this sharing the screen.
Okay.
It is in the process, ma'am. I think it will
come. Okay. So one aspect we need to speak about the mental health of children is that when they again start to school, we should not in the position to tell that she is not fine or he is not fine. We should prepare them for future schoolings also. We should prepare them for their education in as well. So we need to train them. As per the research, people are telling that students have forgotten all the process of education. Like, excuse me, I'll share it again. Is it fine, sir? Can you see me? Can you see? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, it's fine.
Okay, okay, yes, fine. Ma'am. So, a report says that more than 3 million kids are at risk of mental health problems resulting from the pandemic. Yes, it is exactly true that many kids are affected by the mental health issues. So, we need to concentrate. As parents, we are responsible for their mental health and their physical health also. So 3 million kids are affected during this pandemic. That means within this 2 years, many kids are affected. So we can see the difference. When the children are going to school, they enjoy a lot, they have friends, they chat a lot, they play a lot. But after this lockdown started, at the beginning, maybe they were very enjoying, but as days goes on, they have a boredom. They are feeling that they are missing everything. Most children are having issues regarding their future. So what is going to happen? Especially the kids from 10th standard and 12th standard, they are most afraid now. Their future is a question mark. So this is the major problem when we are facing now at this pandemic. And we can't even guess what else is going to happen in the future also. So third wave is getting ready. So we should prepare our children for everything. So we need to give them a stronger mindset. We need to give them a stronger mental health. We need to give them a sound mind so that they can face anything in their life. So 1 in 8 children and young people have a diagnosable mental health problem. This is also a proven fact that 1 in 8 children are affected with mental health problem, diagnosable problem. This is a major aspect we need to concentrate. Like people most of these families are not aware of this. So we psychologists have a major role to create an awareness. In the schools also, they have to create an awareness like children should be concentrated, children should be taken care of. So this is one of the important aspects in the life of the kids. So as a psychologist, as a parents, we need to take care of their entire mental health. We need to speak to them. We need to support them. We need to give them the assurance. We need to reassure a lot to them to ensure about their mental health. We need to make them to speak out. That is a major important thing in the aspect of mental health. We need to make them speak out. So when children are speaking out their problems, most of the problems will be solved. Most of the children are not doing that. Even I have experience with the kids sometime later. So children are not ready to open up. So as the current scenario is, children are more intelligent, social media. They are very addicted to the internet. They are trying to interact with their friends through the social media. There is no transparency in their relationships. Their relationships are being questionable. So this is the most painful scenario where we are facing. Our future generations are getting in a wrong way, as I feel. This is my opinion, actually. So we need to give them the assurance that they are going to be okay. Everything will be all right soon. So they have to come back. They have to open up. They have to tackle everything in their life. So this is important. So speaking out matters a lot. So what does this mean? Speak out, share your concerns with them. First, we need to show them concern that we are here. We are ready to listen to them. We are here to speak to them. This is the most important thing. So put yourself in your child's shoes. Empathy is very important. We should have that empathy in us. Like, we have to hear their problem as a major point of view. So otherwise, children are not interested to tell their problems to us. We have to listen to them. We have to understand what they are trying to communicate. So yes, listen to what they say. So whenever a child is trying to communicate to you, you have to listen to them. So ask how you can help. It is important aspect again. So you should be knowing that how you can help the children, how you can make the children to come out of the problem. So keep the conversation open. The children should know, the kids should know that if he or she is coming and telling you a problem, that will be solved by you. The children should have the confidence in her, like whenever she comes to speak to you, you will be able to solve all their problems. The transparency is very important. Only talk when you both have time. So this is one more important thing, because children are in the mood of playing or children are in the mood of something else. Well, that time we cannot disturb them to speak out. At that time we cannot ask them to communicate with us. That time we cannot force them to do anything. So whenever the child gets time, we have to make some arrangements for that, and we have to hear for the child's speech. So understand if they aren't ready to talk. So this is also a major thing, because if the children is not ready to open up, we cannot force them to tell anything, because out of hurry or out of scariness, they'll tell something else which is not relevant. So talk to a professional for expert help. If you feel that your child is affected, if you feel that your child's mental health is somewhat disturbed, you have to seek for a help. There is no harm in seeking help when there is a need. So this is not a bad thing that you cannot talk to anyone else, or you cannot seek for help, or nobody is there to help you. There are lots of people can give you a hand when you are in need. So you have to concentrate on your child's mental health. You should know when to. Is it fine, sir?
Yes, ma'am. You can go ahead.
So unexpressed emotions will never die. They are buried alive, will come forth later in uglier ways. So as adults, we have experienced a lot in this, I guess, because when the unexpressed emotions are inside us, we cannot handle it. Sometimes it may be burst out. It may be uglier ways. It may be coming out sometime later. So in same way in children also, we have to allow them to express whatever the emotions they have. We have to allow them to communicate freely through their feelings, through their nonverbal communications. So these are all the major things we have to concentrate when it comes to mental health. So when we have a stigma like boys shouldn't cry, girls shouldn't do that, boys shouldn't do that. So that is actually wrong. It's a kind of a wrong parenting. We have to train them. We have to tell them. We have to encourage them. If they are having any problem, they are free to expose. They have the independence to expose whatever the emotions they feel. So this is the another important aspect when it comes to mental health, because when you suppress all your emotions in your heart, when you suppress all your emotions within you, that will come out, and we can't imagine what will happen in the future. So that may reflect in their future behaviors. When they grow older, that will reflect in a bad way. It shows them as a bad person. So that is not actually a good. So emotions should be expressed whenever it is possible, however it is possible. Emotions should be expressed. Either it may be anger, it may be happiness, it may be a sadness, it may be a crying. Whatever it is, a child should be free to expose what kind of emotion or he or she is feeling. That is absolutely a good thing. When he or she tries to express all her emotions, she'll be free. Her heart will be very cool and light. So in that way, they will be able to manage whatever the problems they face. So in anxiety is real in children. This is very true. But most of the parents will not listen because they doesn't have time to speak to the children. They doesn't have that much importance in the matter of mental health. As I have experienced, many parents are telling children are imitating others. Children are telling that they are watching some movie. They are telling something which they saw in the movie. But many children will be telling the truth. So only few parents are understanding how their children are feeling. So fear, worried about the loved ones, lack of emotional support, and experiencing a lots of change in short space of time, such as moving house or school. So during this pandemic, children may be experiencing a lot in their families, lot in their from their parents. There may be economical crisis. There may be a death of the family member, maybe a grandparent or maybe a relative. So child may be depressed, child may be thinking about all those sufferings inside her. So we need to talk to them. We need to give them space to express their emotions as well. So lack of emotional support is one of the another important point where children are not aware of where to dump their where to pour out their problems and where to tell where to seek help. So there is a problem with the children and the parents. So the communication there had a problem, like they doesn't know when to communicate, how to communicate. These are all the major problems when children experience during these times. So children should be free, children should have the freedom to expose. So we should validate their feelings. This is something good actually. So when their children, when the children are telling, like they have some problem, we should validate. So we have to be very kind to the children, listen to their problem, understand their needs first. So what are all the problems, what are all the needs they have, we should understand. Educate them about the situation. This is also important as well, because we need our children to understand ourselves, understand our situation, understand our family members. So that they can easily overcome if there is a problem, if there is a major issue, they can able to understand, they can able to accept. Acceptance is the major problem even adults face today. So they there is a problem with the family, like parents will not tell anything to the students, children's or children will not communicate anything to the parents because parent may be scolding, parents may be always quarreling. So that is not an actual family, because children should have the freedom to communicate. So when parents are in the right position, when parents are in a good relationship with the children, that reflects a lot on their behavior. When we, for example, when parenting is very authoritative, children will be grown up, grow up in the same way. So when we shout to our children, shout to a child, and he or she may be reflecting the same way when we will not be expecting. So when we have a kid or when we have a children below at age of 7 or six, we should be very concentrating, we should be very careful what are all the words we speak, how our behavior is, how we are acting, how we are doing such things. So we should be concentrated. Children may be watching us all the time, but we may not be knowing it. So this is important. As a parent, we have to ensure that we have to give the best for our kids, we have to grow them up in a good way. So validating their feelings is also an important thing when it comes to your mental health. So mental health comprises of all the aspects, physical, emotional, and spiritual. All the aspects are concerned in it. So we should concentrate on all those things. So we have to tell the kids that it is okay to be not okay. They should not be feeling very low. They should not have that inferiority complex, like I cannot do it. I'm not a good person. I'm ashamed, like that. It is okay to feel like that. It is not, there is no harm in feeling the same way. So the children is okay to scared, to be scared, to be ashamed, to be sad, to be upset. So whatever the problem, what all the things it is having, children or a child is having, it is okay. Tell them that there is no harm in feeling such way. When you go into that situation, automatically you will find the solutions to come out. You will have the ability to face all those stuff. So you just train them. If you are getting failure, it is okay, fine, get up and run away. So that you will learn whatever problems you face in the failure. Next time when you face the same problem, you are able to understand what it is exactly. So that is, this should be trained. Children should be trained in such a way. So how to identify the children are anxious? So there are lots of nonverbal communications. Children try to tell us that they are very anxious or they are very depressed, they are very stressed. So we can easily identify if some children is not well, some children is not communicating with each other, they are not easygoing, we can easily identify. So they'll be alone all the time. Sometimes they are feeling sad or crying. Sometimes they'll be crying without no reason. They'll show their tantrums. So we have to concentrate why it is happening. If some children is crying for something, object or something else, there is no issue. If some children is crying for no reason, we have to concentrate on what exactly the situation is and why the children is behaving in such a way. So we need to concentrate, we need to talk to them, we need to assure them that we are there for them to help them out in what are all the ways they are facing the problem. So throw tantrums and irritability. Children may be irritable all the time, and they'll be if we are trying to communicate to them, they will not be ready. They'll showing their tantrums. So this easily shows that they are anxious or depressed, or they'll be disturbed mentally. So we need to speak about that. We need to speak to them in a common, in a confidential place, so that the child may be open up to their parents or to their loved ones or to their the person whom they trust a lot. So this is also a good aspect. So we need to speak to the children. We need to understand why they are in the way, why they are behaving in such a way. So feelings of hopelessness and lack of confidence. These may be, these are all the key points where we can understand how, why the child is anxious, or why the child is behaving in a such a way. So they should not feel all those negative aspects. So we should give them hope. We should give them confidence. We should tell them that they can do anything in their life. They can face anything. We have to train them in such a way. So we have to give them a hope in the life. We have to give the light. We have to give the energy to them to overcome all the problems, overcome all the issues and minor steps they have to face. So this is, we have to train them. We have to give them all the required energy to them. So when they are feeling hopeless, we need to tell them that we need to tell them a lot of stories that we have faced, so they can learn easily from the parents, because parents have been the role model for the kids all the time. So especially mother have to tell them, mother have to teach them, they have to tell them lots of stories. Actually, storytelling is a good habit when it's come to mental health of the children. When we tell them a story as an example, they will learn easily. We can tell them real life experience, or we can tell them the fantasized stories, but children will learn a story, learn from the story a lot. They have to understand the core concept of the story, so that they will be able to apply it in their daily life, apply it in their future also. So storytelling is the good aspect. Storytelling is the good practice in growing up the children. So that helps a lot. So they may be avoiding social situations, not showing interest in the play activities. So by this, we can easily identify the children is not well. Children is not physically or emotionally well. So we can ask them what is the exact problem. They will not be ready to mingle with their friends, or they will not show any interest in their usual pleasurable activities. So they'll be alone, all alone. They'll be crying. They'll be telling something, they'll avoid everyone. They will be, they want to be alone all the time. So as a mother, we can easily identify our kids' mental health, how they react, how they feel, and in what way they are affected. So we need to talk to them. We need to guide them. We need to give them the confidence to overcome all those hurdles they face. So lack of sleep and appetite. So this will be the major problem with the kids we face today, because after the lockdown started, people have children have changed their routine as much as possible. So they wake up late in the morning. Sometimes they skip their food, maybe breakfast, lunch or dinner. They skip. Sometimes they may be always inside the phone or always using the internet, and they'll not be having time for proper sleep and proper eating habits. So we should give them a routine. Like we should give them a proper care. Like whenever they have to sleep, whenever they have to eat, we should guide them. We should be concentrating on their health also. So it's very important. As being a mother, it is very difficult to handle all those situations at the same time. But we have to concentrate, because when the children are going to school, there may be a routine. Like in the morning, they'll do this regularly. They'll go to the school, and in the school, they will be studying. They'll be having lunch. They'll be playing. And when returning back, they will be doing their homeworks. It's a kind of a daily routine they'll be following for so long. Suddenly there is a break in between. Like they have the holidays for a long time. So every family's habit have been changed. So we need to bring back all those habits again, so that the children will be occupied all the time. So they will not be having any time to think about the negative aspects or think about the problems around them. So we need not to tell the children that whatever negative things happen in our family, like somebody is died or something is happening around us. We have to tell that in a way, like children, whatever the mindset, whatever the age they have, how will they understand? What is their position? We need to analyze all those stuffs, and after that only we have to tell if anything happens in our life. So we cannot, we don't have to tell all the news we hear, all the news we see, So already we may be in the position where it is very scary, like things are happening around us, many the COVID spread is a lot, they are spreading more and more, we have to take care of our kids also. So we should not panic them, we should keep them always happy, we should spend some time with the children. So these may affect the sleep and appetite of the children also. If they are not sleeping properly, they cannot eat well. If they're not eating well, their physical health automatically gets affected. So we should concentrate in both of the aspects as well. So your child's mental health is more important than their grades. Let them be little, let them be creative, let them play often. In short, let them be the children. So this is one of the major point where all the children suffer, because most of the parents started telling you have long holidays, you are wasting your time, you are not learning anything, you are not doing this, not doing that. So let them see the children, what is wrong in that? They can practice, they can do whatever they want, right? Education is very important, that is another aspect, but their emotional well-being is also equally important as such. So we need to give them the freedom that they can do anything else. We have to reward them, we have to appreciate whatever thing they do, even it may be a little one or it may be a bigger one, we have to appreciate them. When children are appreciated, their behavior will be easily and automatically changed. We can change their behavior in whatever way we want. So we have to let the children be the children. So tips to nurture your child's mental health. So there are lots and lots of tips available. So I'll be concentrating only on a few aspects. So I'll tell you what are all the things we can give. So first we have to guide. Give a reason and explain why tasks and rules are important. So when children are growing up in a normal family or rich family, whatever it is, we need to tell them we are responsible for telling them this is our family, this is our principles, or all those stuff we have to explain them. Use gentle, non-controlling language for tasks and rules. So this is also important, because when we tell them in an authoritative manner, children will not do anything for us. When we are telling in a soft voice, when we telling in a pleasing voice, automatically they will get the interest, they will do whatever we are telling them. So include choices that give kids control within the acceptable limits. So we should tell them these are all the boundaries, these are all the limits we have, so you can do whatever you want in this, within this boundaries. So we should give them that this is what we can, this is to till this extent we can go, or after this extent we cannot go. These are all the boundaries they should know, they should understand first. So we should give choices to the children. So this is all what we are having here, this is all about we are in this family, so you can decide according to that. So that some children will be having that mindset, okay, this is my family, I'll do whatever within this limit. But some children may not be accepting that. You need to educate them, like this is what it is, you should be in this thing, but in a soft way. So this is what you see or expect using impersonal statements. So you have to tell them indirectly, at the same time directly. You have to tell them this is what we want and this is the way you have to behave. So but you have to understand the children in such a way that they are enjoying the things, that they are accepting whatever things happening. So employ songs that describe routines and rules. So they have to enjoy as well, they can do whatever they want. So you can give them some rewards like chocolates or stars, whatever it is. You can actually make them happy. So we have to ensure that they are not alone. We are there for all the time. We are there all the time. They have to communicate with us. They have to. They should be ready to tell us what exactly the problem is, so that we can do something. We can try to help them. We can try to make them come out of the problem. So we have to always reassure all the time that we are here. We should. They should be in a position to tell us whatever the problem comes. Especially when it comes to girl children, we should give this assurance all the time, always. 24/7, we should make them understand that we are here. If something bad happens, someone misbehaves with them, they have to be very careful. They have to be cautious that they should tell this problem to someone else. They should not be scared of all the problems. So they should face whatever the situation is. They should overcome. So this is actually an important point where mental health plays a major role. So we have to give them the assurance all the time. So we have to keep them telling, keep on telling it, you are amazing just the way you are. So let the children accept themselves. They have to accept them as a person. They have to accept them whom they are. So from the childhood, if they are practicing that, when they are growing in as an adult, they can do things in the best way. They'll be a good person in the society. So often you have to ensure that you are amazing, you are the way you are best all the time, you are good in a way, you are doing all the things in a good way. So you should be following it, you should be continuing all the steps in your future. You have to keep on telling the children. So when you appreciate the children for a task, the children may get motivated and they will be trying to achieve more in their life. So whatever it is, it may be ugly or it may be not good, you have to appreciate whatever the child does. So that is actually a good thing when parenting comes into the play. We should understand all those steps when we are with children. We can learn a lot. We can understand a lot from a children. There are logical aspects. There are lots of logical aspects. There are lots of strategies they use. So we also can study whatever it is. So make them learn new things. So during this pandemic, we can teach them a lot of new things like cooking, like doing household chores or gardening or planting, whatever it is, you can make them learn. So children below, till the age of 7, they can learn whatever they want that maybe easily they can store in their brain. So we can make them learn a new thing, whatever they wish. They may be dance, maybe singing, maybe slam, whatever they feel they can learn. So you can make the opportunity for the children to learn new things so that they are occupied all the time. They will not be having any time to think about anything else in their free time. So if they are willing to do whatever, if they are willing to do anything else, you can support them. You can guide them. You should not tell that, no, this is not possible. No, you cannot do that, all those steps. Whatever the limits you have, you can try in a new thing within your limits. So you can guide your children so that they will learn something new during this pandemic. They can master their skills in that particular aspect. But maybe that will take their life to the greater position. They may be changing their life after this pandemic also. So when they go to school, they can express this as a new skill I have learned. So I wish to continue in that so that teachers also may be happy. So we should teach them a new skill, whatever it is. It may be a paid one, it may be a paid one, or within a house, whatever it is, we can make them to learn a new thing so that they will be occupied all the time. So they will not be having any time to think about the negative vibrations or negative things. Feeling safe and secure, that feelings of safety and security, we have to give them. We have to ensure them that they are very safe. They are concentrated. They are very always. We have to ensure that so that the children may be free. They may be seeking help whenever they want. If they are not feeling that, if they are not having the feeling of safe security, they may not seek out for help. They will not be open up and speak out what are all the problems they are facing. So we have to ensure them all the time that they are very safe, they are very secure. The feelings of security is a major aspect in the relationship. That bond develops between the parent and the children comes to play here, because the security, the feeling of secureness is a major aspect in the relationship. So we have to assure them that they are very safe, they are always secured, they are always concerned, always concentrated. These are all the assurance, these are all the promises we have to make to the children when they are at our homes or when they are with us. So unplug your kids. So this is the very difficult task we face today, because people, many parents, as I have seen, they'll be giving their mobile phones to the children. So the children may be silent for a long time. Sometimes it may be 4 hours, sometimes it may be 5 hours, but that is actually a wrong notion. We have to limit their screen time. Maybe you can tell them 1 hour in a day you can use your mobile, or 1 hour and 2 hours in a day you can watch some videos or those stuff. You can engage them in outdoor activities. You can make them to do play in the sand, you play in the water, whatever it is, you can make them to play outdoor activities. You should not dump your child in a one place, like giving their mobile phones, giving their tablets or whatever it is. You should not make them sit in one place. So most of the mothers will be doing this because they'll be having a hectic time with their work from home schedule. So they'll be giving the children their phones or tablets. So they'll be including all the watching all the videos or playing some other games. They'll be all the time inside the phone. So that is actually a wrong thing. It affects the brain also. It affects physical health also, and it also affects psychological well-being also. So we should not, as a parent, we should not do that. We should encourage our kids to play outdoor activities. But as of now, these generation kids are missing the outdoor activities because of technology. So we should tell them what environment is, what outside world, how it feels, how the traditional games are planned, how the traditional games are played. So we should tell them all those stuff. They can learn all the aspects, all the scientific reasons behind our traditional games. So we can give them their tradition as a good thing. So yes, give importance to outdoor games. So they have to play outside. Sometimes they have to play under the sun for 1 hour or 2 hours. That is all actually a good thing also. Because many children are playing with the smartphone or playing with the computer, TV, whatever it is, they'll have some vision problems also. So we can limit the time. We can give them at least 1 hour a day or 2 hours in a day. We can limit the time and we can make them to play outside the house. They can come out of their comfort zone. They can know their talents actually. They can easily understand, okay, I can run, I can walk, or I can jump, whatever they are doing. They can easily identify what problem, what talent they have. So outdoor games gives a major happiness. Outdoor games are very important for children, especially these generation kids should have outdoor games as their routine. Okay, so family time is also important as well. Many of the families, as at present, they are spending a lot of time with their children, with their spouse, all those stuff. But when everything becomes normal, when school started, when offices started, they'll be not having any time to spend. They'll be meeting at the dining table or meeting at the dinner time. At once in a day, they'll meet. So that is actually a good thing. But sometimes some families does not have time for that also. Actually, we have to plan at least a half an hour to spend with our family. We need to discuss our things to our kids also. We can discuss our economical aspects to our kids also. And we can discuss our problems to the kids also. They'll be giving innovative answers, innovative ideas. Maybe sometimes they cannot understand few things, but in few families, they are kids are taking decisions in their major problems. So this is actually a good thing. We have to give the training to the kids to how to handle all the problems, how to face all the problems, or how to create a schedule for the solutions. So we can make the children to train in all those household things also. So family time is important. So that children's mental health will be improvised. That may be enhanced when they are with the family, when they are connected with the family. That connection is very important. We should greet each other. We should talk to each other. We should have that bond with each other in our family. Maybe there may be a lot of siblings in one family. They should have a bond within them. So that they in future they may be helping each other. So that is a good thing. So we have to plan a daily routine for a kid. So as pandemic started, everything has changed. They are they'll be waking up late. Sometimes they'll not brush up. They'll have some coffee or tea or milk, whatever it is. So we have to plan a routine. Morning you should do that. Afternoon you should do this. Evening you should do this. So we have to give a plan. We have to keep the kids always engaged. You can make whatever it is. You can give them a music training. You can give them a dance training. So whatever it is up to you. And you can plan a daily routine for a kid, so that the kid may be doing in all the things in an organized way, so that when their school started or when they are going to some other someone's place, someone's relative's house, they may be organized. They feel that proud of you. Like as a parent, we are giving them a good training from our home. So that helps the children. When the school starts, they can easily organize the things whenever they have tasks to do. So daily routine is also an important thing. So we have to give them whatever it is, maybe household things also we can give, or coloring or playing, whatever it is, but you should plan a routine for the children. So tell them to practice meditation and yoga. Many children will not do that because they'll feel boring when meditating or doing yoga. So we can make them practice all those stuffs, because meditation is actually a good thing. It gives you inner peace when you practice meditation. That will give you the feeling of calmness or feeling of fulfillment within you, so that you can understand what exactly is happening. So at least for a half an hour in a day, you have to tell the kid to meditate. You can join with them to meditate or yoga, whatever it is. That is actually good for a physical health and as well as the mental health also. So yoga and meditation plays a major role in mental health, so that lots of problems, lot has been reduced. So you have to encourage our children, encourage our kids to do meditation. Or at least if you can't control the kids at your home, you can join them some other classes, meditation, yoga classes, lots of are available online. So you can tell them to join the courses and you can make them do meditation and yoga. So coloring for relaxation. This is one important and relaxing habit children have to do that. So when they color, they will be feeling very happy. Their happy hormones actually excited. So they will be feeling very happy. They'll be enjoying it. So allow them to color, maybe in the walls or maybe in the ground or maybe in the paper. Let them freely color. Actually, color speaks a lot to us. When the kids are coloring, it is reflecting their emotions. It is reflecting their feelings. So you just tell them to color or whatever they feel or whatever they want. That colors may pour out all the negative emotions from inside the kid. So you allow them to color whatever they feel. You just tell them to do what they feel, like whatever they are feeling inside them, they can color it or they can paint or they can draw something else. So you just allow the kid to color. Coloring is actually a good relaxation habit. Most of the northern countries or western countries are following all those coloring habits, art therapy and crafts therapy. They are giving lots and lots to the kids so that they are enjoying it. So teach them gratitude. So this generation kids are lacking this, as I feel, because we have to tell them how to greet everyone, how to be very grateful to others. You have to say thank you, you have to say sorry, or you have to ask for help, you have to get permission, you have to wish them good morning, good afternoon, good night, everything we need to teach them. So charity begins at home. When we teach everything at our home, they will be a good person in the society. So when they go out, when they grow up in the society, they should be respected as a person. So gratitude plays an important role in growing up a children. So we should teach them, we should tell them. Grandparents always used to tell us that we should have a proper organized parenting. So now we are changed into a neutral family. So we'll not be having grandparents at our home sometimes. So we are not able to teach our kids also. We doesn't have time to spend with them. So gratitude is actually a good habit. And if possible, we can make the children to have a gratitude journal, so that they can be writing all the things happened in a day, like how to whom they are very thankful to, or to whom they are feeling very bad, to whom they are actually willing to create a bond. So these things will help them to regulate their emotional bond. So gratitude journal is actually a good thing. So we can practice the children. Like if they are in a position to understand that what is gratitude journal or what is gratitude, we can make them. Otherwise, we can teach them, this is the right manner, this is the right way you have to speak, this is the right way you have to act. These are all the aspects we have to concentrate when the kid is in our home. So when they start to home, when they start to school, before that, we need to train all the aspects regarding this thing. So involve in imaginative play. So children should always have imaginative play in their life, because their creativity, their imagination gives them a very good mindset. So they can easily overcome depression from that. So imaginative plays are important in the kids. You have to enhance the kids. And now these days, kids are lagging in this, I guess, because the technology takes over to the part of imaginative play. So we have to tell them that you should consider like this, you should give them a scenario, you should act like that. All those stuff you have to teach them. Actually, you can have fun with your kids. This is the right time for the parents to engage with your kids. This is the right time for the kids also associate with their parents, so you can also enjoy with the kids. You make them do some imaginative play. You can see your kids' imagination is unbelievable. You can feel that also. So make them to involve in imaginative plays. So healthy habits is very important. You should ensure that your children is following a healthy habit, like eating healthy, doing some exercise. At least they should be active or getting plenty of sleep. Children should sleep at least 9 to 10 hours in a day. So you have to ensure all the aspects that they are following it or not. So this is also important. So it takes a grit. So you have to be very resilient. You have the guts to open up about your kid, or your kid should open up to you. You have to identify exactly what the problem is. You should know the severity of the problem, and you should seek for help. So if there is a treatment procedure also, you have to ready to accept it. You cannot feel that, oh, my child is affected, I cannot accept this, all those steps you should not feel. You should be ready to give treatment if needed. So that can save the child's life also. So this is very important when parenting. You have to accept whatever happens to your child. If it is in a positive way or it may be in a negative way, you should first accept, and you have to react to the situation. You have to safeguard your children from the negative happenings. So you should be very strong in that. Whatever it is, you should face it in a way. So childhood should be very happy. It shouldn't hurt to be a child. The child should cherish each and every moment in their life, so that my childhood was like this, my childhood was like this. So if they are going to school after this pandemic, they can share all their happy experiences with their friends, with their teachers, and confirm we can analyze the mindset of the children after they go for the school. So if they are very happy at home, that will be reflecting there in the education also. They will be having a good mindset. They will be having excellent study habits. So allow the child to be a child. So they will be enjoying their childhood. So this is for mothers. This is for parents. Your children will become what you are. So be what you want them to be. So parents are the role model for the children. So we have to act in a way that they are understanding, they are observing us, they are imitating us. So we have to be in the position to teach them, this is us, this is dad, this is the mom, this is their positions. So you have to be in a better position, like your mom, like your dad. So this is also important. So don't worry that children never listen to you. Worry that they are always watching you. So this is a nice quote that I liked a lot, because sometimes we may be feeling that children are not listening to us. They are not in a way. They are not like us. Sometimes they may be feeling that, but you know, silently they may be imitating us. Silently they may be watching us. So we don't have to worry about that. So children are always in a track of ours only. So we should be in the right person. We should be in the right position to guide them. We should be in the right place to take them where they want. So this is what you should be, a friend to your kids. This is what is I tried to communicate today. I wanted to tell you. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. It was a very nice, wonderful session. And you have a lot of input, strategies, all those things. And you explained very well how important of the children's mental health. So this is now question and session. Participant, you can unmute yourself and you can ask the question to the resource person directly. Or you can put your question in the chat box.
You can feel free to ask me anything. I'm ready to answer.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, sir.
It was an excellent presentation, madam. Congratulations for this. It was a crisp and very directive, very clear cut direction. Ma'am, I have one question that in a certain situation where child is consistently failing due to the laziness. Wherein he is supposed to stretch, and how in a very polite way it can be convinced to the child to give up laziness, because it has become a habit which he is not able to give up.
Yes, it's a kind of
interrupt you. Yes. You can change your screen time. It's I think it's the portrait side. You can put in the landscape.
Is it fine, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, now it's okay.
Okay. So we have to train the children. We have to reward them. We have to tell them that if you do this, you'll be having a surprise. All those steps. You have to make the child to come out of the couch. So they should be out of the comfort zone. When the children are ready to come out of their comfort zone, they can do whatever they want. But that is a major difficult task we face during this pandemic, because children are not ready. They'll be feeling lazy all the time. They'll be in front of the TV all the time. So we should reward them. We should make them understand this is what it is. This is what it happens. So you should give them rewards. You should give them surprises all the time. It is not possible for all the time, but sometimes you have to make them, there is a surprise for them. So if they are doing this task, they'll be getting this. Like conditioning, you can tell the children to work. That will actually help.
Ma'am, rewards has to be attractive enough to make bring them over the couch.
Yeah, it is also an important thing, right? If it is attractive, children automatically change their behavior. So you need not to be very costly in this in the way. You can give simple rewards, but they should enjoy that. Whatever it is, it may be simple or it may be a grand one, but they have to enjoy. You should know what are the likes of the child. If the child is liking video games or it may be a chocolate, whatever it is, you can tell them, if you do this task, I'll allow you to watch videos for this time, or I'll give you this chocolate if you do this. If you complete this task in a fast way, you can get all those things you want. So you can tell them in this polite way. So authoritating or ordering will not help the children to move out of their couch. So we should be very concentrated on that.
Especially the children who are entering into the teenage. Who are entering into the teenage, like 12 years old children. They are rewarding, it can be converted into bribing also. Like they may not work, that may not work always, or they may not work without taking a reward.
Yes. So you have to make the children understand why this is important, why this task is important. I understand during those teenage time, during those puberty time, they'll be having mood fluctuations. So in some way, you have to convince them. Yeah, or you can act like we are not in a position to do that task. Only your child can help. Only your child can convince. Only your child can able to do that. You can convince in that way. It may work sometime. Emotionally, we can handle them. It may work. Sometimes, not all the time. You have to change your perspectives all the time. So completed, you can you have to think a lot for other aspects also, other tasks also.
Thank you very
much. First of all, congratulations for your very nice PPT and the presentation and the session also. Thank you very much. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I have one little doubt. In your presentation, you presented that till the age of 7, right? Till the age of 7, the children, whatever the outcome the parents can expect from, it is the correct time, 0 to 7 years age. Okay, the emotions, whatever it is. So suppose a child doesn't have, could not express all these things. Okay. Maybe in the lifespan of, suppose we are calibrating 25, 50, 75, 100% till the age of 80. So how it will affect their remaining part of the life till before 80, before getting the adult age. Can you please?
Oh, how we are going to train the children? If it is not happening before 7, how we are going to train the children?
Yeah, means 25% maybe before 7, or I don't know, the percentage wise calibrating the according to your psychological thing. So if it is up to 25% or 30%, even 50%. So remaining part from 7 to 80. So how it will affect, and how it will be cleared, if at all.
One simple aspect we need to understand is we have to make curious about the tasks. So after 7 years of age, they'll be in the school, they'll be learning a lot of new things, they'll be interested in a lot of new aspects of their life. So automatically the children will learn. If they are not learning also, we have to make the children to be very curious. They should be in a way that they need to learn. So we have to teach them, we have to train them. So we have to give each and every aspect, we have to give each and minute suggestions to the kids to learn new things. So parents are should be in that position to train the children in that way. So that will only aspect we can help the children. Maybe teachers and parents are the important persons in their life. Whatever they say, that is their major thing. They will take it as a major thing. So when it comes to puberty, there may be peer pressures, there may be peer influences. So they may learn from their society, learn from their friends. So after 7 to 10, you can easily train the children, but it will take some time. Before 7, there is no time limit at all. They can learn easily, they can grab easily. So after 7, after 10, it will take some time for the children to learn, to adapt for the new things. So being a parent, we have a major role in concentrating on what they have to learn and what they not to learn.
Okay.
But it will take some time.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Ma'am, there are a lot of positive feedbacks in the chat box, I can see, from Anita ma'am, Dr. Vidya ma'am, and Alamel ma'am, and Vishal ma'am. So there are a lot of positive feedbacks, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. Actually, I was asking Suresh sir for a long time, I guess. Last pandemic also I tried, but this time I got the chance, and thank you so much for that. Thank you, Suresh sir, for this wonderful opportunity. Thank you, everyone. And you
thank
can
you,
ask
ma'am.
Me if you have any questions.
Yes, ma'am. Participant, any question is there, you can ask. Otherwise, you can go for the vote of thanks. We have a couple of minutes only, so any other questions you can ask to the resource person as the last question. Ma'am, I think there is no question. We'll go for the vote of thanks.
Sure.
It was a very wonderful session. Today we had the 442 session. This is a very needy topic, like children's mental health. As per your data, it's very, we have to concentrate to the children's mental health, because you said 3 million kids are affected. So
yes.
It's not a joke. We have to concentrate more. This is the third area. And all the mental health professionals, as well as people in the society also, they have to take care. And 1 in 8 children affecting means it is not a good thing also. So 1 in 8. So you have a lot of tips, ma'am, giving a reason and the guide, you said, no? So using gentle language, how to deal with the people. And we have to make sure they are safe, they are feeling safe, and limiting. We have to make sure their screening time is very less. And we have to teach them the practicing yoga and meditation. And we have to give the activity like coloring and all those things for the relaxation. We have we have to teach them a gratitude. It's very, very important, actually. From the children, they have to learn how to do the gratitude and all those things. And very nice session. And finally, he gives a wonderful quote, ma'am. Don't worry that the children never listen to you. And
that's actually one of my favorite quote. That's why I want to tell that.
Correct, ma'am. They are always actually watching. So
yes.
Watching us. So we have to do our activity best in terms, because they are a learner. They should not follow rank practices from us. So thank you very much, and kindly accepted our gratitude on behalf of American College Madurai, MS Chellamuthi Institute, and Red Pond Educational Psychological Research Center Madurai, Madras School of Social Work Chennai, and Psycho-Oncological Association Turkey. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you very much, all the participants for traveling all along the 1 year. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And I request all the participants, whoever is not vaccinated yet, so kindly vaccinated. So it is very dangerous now. So be very safe. Take care of your kids and take care of yourself also. This is my kind request.
Thank you, ma'am. Participant, you can check in the chat box. There is already, we put the feedback and certification links in the beginning itself. It will be there. You can keep it. I think one or two participants asked, like Monica, ma'am,
You can scroll out in the chat box. You can take the feedback form. It is there in the beginning itself. Anyway, we will try to put in the groups also. I think Vidya ma'am asked to send it again. Ma'am, it is there in the chat box. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. I think Monica got it. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Participant, we are going to have yet another wonderful session tomorrow. Until then, bye-bye. Kanika, ma'am, it is there in the beginning itself, ma'am. You can scroll the chat box and you can take it. Thank you, all the participants.